Case number three is interesting for a lot of reasons. He's a 40-year-old, right-hand dominant, married, E8. He's a senior NCO, and he's also a ranger. He's a special ops guy with multiple concussive events, including two grade 2 concussions, two grade 3 concussions, two blunt head trauma, one of which was an assault, which he was treated in a hospital and while he was on leave, and two blast exposures. He's had a lot of cognitive trauma in the course of his career. Why did he come in? His wife insisted that he come in. She noticed that he was having difficulties with his memory. She noticed that he was having difficulty. He seemed a little slower. And so she said, look, you've got 18 years in. You're going to be leaving the military soon. You got to go in. This is a soldier who was reluctant to seek services, even though he's had problems in the past. He's a very tough guy, a seasoned military man, but unfortunately, we can see the potential residual impact of these multiple concussions that he has had from the various assaults. Looking at the data, we see that we again have a valid profile. Each of the VI domains says yes, we have a valid profile there. His composite memory is a considerable concern. Consistent with his wife's concerns and his that he acknowledged to me as well during the clinical interview, he's functioning at the fifth percentile. So we have a mild to moderate impaired composite memory. There isn't much difference between visual and verbal memory. We've got some issues going on here with the mesial temporal lobe that need to be addressed further. I'm certainly going to want to get an MRI on this soldier. We have a issue here going on with reaction time. He's only at the fourth percentile. Now, this guy is a ranger. He's an elite soldier. His reaction time is at the fourth percentile. That's incongruent with what we would expect, even though he's 40 years of age. And I'll tell you, when I interviewed him, he looked really good. I mean, he was in really good shape. So we have some concerns here that we're going to certainly want to address. But before we move on to the questionnaires, I think it would be instructive to look at some of these domains and some of the scores there. For example, if we take a look at the shifting attention test, which can be a very challenging test, we see that he actually did fairly well here. Now here's a soldier that's used to rules. He's used to responding rapidly. And so he actually did pretty well on that. Whereas with some of the other tests, which are a little more boring, as we might say, where he has to really, really focus in for an extended period of time, like the continuous performance test, where there were seven commission errors, placing him at the first percentile, which is in the severely impaired range, or the Stroop test, where we're looking at complex reaction time and Stroop reaction time there. Again, over a period of time, he seems to do more poorly there. So we have some discrepancies here, and we're certainly going to want to do some more comprehensive neuropsychological assessment with him to determine why we have some of these differences and where that's coming from. But clearly, we have impairment here based upon a history of brain injury that certainly needs to be addressed. Taking a look at the Epworth Sleepiness Scale, the ESS, a score of 4 would indicate that there really isn't a very high chance of daytime dozing here. There's no indication of daytime fatigability, which would explain the poor results in some of the executive function tests. On the sleep quality index, we do see here there are some problems. This is a soldier who has a duration of sleep that is curtailed. This is not an uncommon finding with soldiers, by the way. It's very common to see soldiers sleeping 2, 3, 4 hours a night when they return from theater, and we've determined that we need to get 7 hours of sleep. I mean, there is some variability there, but the research indicates that we need more sleep. So this is an issue for him. Sleep latency is also an issue. It's taking him a little longer to get to sleep, and his sleep is a little bit disturbed. So overall sleep quality is on the poor side. With regard to the PCOS, he's had a number of many traumatic experiences. Our rangers are deployed on average for 105 days to theater. The deployments are very, very intense, and then they come back. And this soldier probably has had, I believe, 6 or 7 or more deployments during the course of his career. And as you can see here, he's doing very well. I think this bodes well for the kind of training that he may have had. He's a very resilient guy. That certainly came across in the interview, and he does not appear to be suffering from post-trauma distress. Likewise, when we look here at the Zung Self-Rating for Depression scale, again, I look at item 19. We don't have a problem there. He's not enjoying things the way he used to a little bit. That's not a big problem there for him, but that may, in fact, be related to some transitions in his career that he might be experiencing now. He does acknowledge that his mind isn't quite as clear, and that came through in the neurocognitive testing. And if we look here at number item 4, he's also having trouble sleeping. He endorses that, so that we have some convergent validity here from the PSQI, the Pittsburgh Sleep Quality, the Zung, and then taking a look at the neurocognitive data, it's probably the case that his sleep problems are bleeding in and contributing also to some of his cognitive issues as well. He is not engaging in any type of substance abuse or any alcohol abuse. The DAST is clean at 0, and his audit score of 3 is not significant. In summary, we have a soldier here who's experiencing some memory problems and some issues with attention processing that need to be addressed. His cognitive flexibility is an area of concern. He seems to be able to hold it together very well on the complex attention test for that short duration, but when it's a longer test, his mind begins to drift a little bit. So this is a soldier that we're going to want to get involved in some occupational therapy. We want to focus upon some attention process training, a DBIC recommended therapy, also some memory enhancement strategies and techniques or therapy, and then we're going to reassess him with the CNS vital signs, see where he's at that point, maybe in 30 to 60 days. If he's still having problems, I'm going to go with a full battery in this soldier.